Warriors, cryptocurrency coming to your bank. We're going to go deep and look at facts, figures, numbers, logic. The freight train has left the building, Warriors, and there's two types of people. People are going to get on it and go for the ride of their life, or people are going to get run over by it. But the fact is, everybody has to get on the train at some point. My name is Coach JV. I am the top health, mindset, and crypto coach in the world. What you believe in your heart, you think in your mind, will eventually become your words and become your reality. If you can see it in your mind, eventually you can hold it right here in your hands. What you repeatedly do gets ingrained in your subconscious mind. What gets ingrained in your subconscious mind becomes an unconscious activity. And what they're doing, Warriors, they're predictive and preemptive programming you to the new quantum financial system, the new banking system. And what they're doing is, you look this way at a pandemic, there's a whole nother narrative going on this way. So we're going to rewatch this video where they dive deep and they hammer on Gary Gensler around the stablecoin. And I'm going to show you facts, figures, numbers, logic on how your banks are already ready to federally charter banks are ready to custody your cryptocurrency. So as the whole narrative goes on, flooding you out of the marketplace, banks are getting prepared, they're getting stabilized, they're getting the infrastructure built so that they can hold your cryptocurrency. Because as Jamie Dimon said, fintech should be scaring the shit out of banks. Paraphrased. All right, so let's watch this video and then we'll dive into facts, figures, numbers, logic to help you take a deep breath and navigate this new crypto space and the quantum financial system.
We will see it soon. Now let me turn to cryptocurrencies. And my time is limited, so I'm going to try to do this as efficiently as I can, Mr. Chairman. But I think I know your position, among other things, is that not all cryptocurrencies are inherently securities, right? That's true.
There are a small number that aren't, but I think that, as Chair Clayton said when he was in front of Congress, I think very many of these facts and circumstances are investor contracts.
So here's my concern. So some are and some aren't is basically what you're saying. And I'm concerned that the SEC has not provided sufficient definition for, and explained how it would apply the Howey test, which I think is the court standard for determining when something is.
So again, that's what the SEC lawsuit against Ripple is all about, to bring in a new Howey test.
Investment contract. So for instance, stable coins do not have an inherent expectation of profit. They're just linked to the dollar. Now you might use them in an attempt to make a profit, but that's a second order activity. Is it your view that stable coins themselves can be securities?
I think it's, Senator, they may well be securities. As Thurgood Marshall wrote in the Reeves opinion, defining the scope of the market that Congress, wished to regulate, Congress painted a broad brush, and it actually included about 35 different things inside the definition of a security in the 33 Act.
I've just got limited time here, so I acknowledge that. Here's my problem, though. I think what you just said was that they may be securities, or that some are securities. To me, a stablecoin doesn't meet the second prong of the Howey test, that there has to be an expectation of profits from the investment. And so if it doesn't meet the Howey test, it looks to me like it's not a security.
All right. So this is a narrative happening. Excuse me. This is a narrative happening behind the scenes, Warriors. So as you're worried about your cryptocurrency portfolio, these are the things that are happening. These are things that are happening at your bank now. Let's take a look at this. Now, I brought this up to you guys in the past, but want to keep you at a 30,000 foot overview so you don't get flooded out of the market. But again, I'll share with you guys, Warriors, you need to have a game plan. If you want to get profits out of this market, you have to be ready with an exit strategy. Because as it goes parabolic, Warriors, it's going to come collapsing back down, I believe 80 to 90%. And the next bear market is where we're really going to build our portfolios to get that next bull run. And then it's going to normalize like the stock market. That's just my opinion. Okay, so this is from Bloomberg. Treasury is pushing to impose bank-like regulations on stablecoins. A U.S. effort to regulate stablecoins favors policies like the lenders, which could jeopardize the future of tokens for firms that refuse to seek federal banking licenses. So what this tells me right here is that they're really pushing it towards banks because they know that there's going to be a modern-day bank run. So what they're going to work to do is regulate the exchanges so hard that they have to come up with the U.S. regulations in America, right? And they have to have the same type of regulation. So here's what's happening behind the scenes with banks. Okay, stablecoins face crackdown. A U.S. discusses risk at council review. The U.S. officials are discussing launching a formal review into whether Tether and other stablecoins threaten the financial stability, scrutiny that could lead to dramatic ramp-up oversight for fast-growing corner of the crypto market, okay? So here we go right here. Bitcoin is coming to hundreds of U.S. banks this year, says crypto custody firm NYDIG. This was back in May 5th, 2021. For the first time, customers of some U.S. banks will soon be able to buy, hold, and sell Bitcoin through their existing accounts, according to a crypto custody firm, NYDIG. Banks are asking for Bitcoin because they can see their customers sending dollars to Coinbase and other crypto exchanges, according to Yan Zhu, president of NYDIG. After rolling out the initial Bitcoin product, NYDIG planned on other services, including debit card rewards paid in Bitcoin and new type of bank account that is FDI insured but pays interest in Bitcoin, they said. Okay. Now, this is important. Okay, so this is just news, right? Well, let's go into the OCC documents. So the OCC documents, I've shared this with you guys since last year, July 22nd, 2020. Federally chartered banks and thrifts may provide custody services for bank or crypto assets. Excuse me. The office, the OCC today published a letter clarifying national banks and federal savings associations authorities to provide cryptocurrency custody service for customers. National and state banks and thrifts have a long provided safekeeping and custody services, including both physical objects and electronic assets. The OCC has specifically recognized the importance of digital assets and the authority for banks to provide safekeeping such as assets since 1998. The letter published today in the OCC concludes that providing cryptocurrency custody services, including holding unique cryptographic keys associated with cryptocurrency, is a modern form of traditional bank activities related to custody services. Crypto custody services may extend beyond the passively holding the keys from safe deposit box, virtual vaults. Whereas I've been telling you this for a long time. So as you get flooded out of the marketplace and they're saying that Bitcoin's a fraud, your banks are already set up, federally chartered banks, to hold your cryptocurrency. So why would they allow federally chartered banks to hold your cryptocurrency if cryptocurrency is a fraud? Why would they be talking about it in the Senate hearings? Why would this be the biggest subject in history right now? This is a massive switch in global economics. Okay, check this out. So this is a news release. This was on January 4th, 2021. Federally chartered banks and thrifts may participate in independent node verification networks and use of stablecoins for payment activities. Okay. The Office of OCC today published a letter clarifying national banks and federal associations, savings associations, authority to participate in an independent node verification network, an INVN, and use stable coins to conduct payment activities and other permissible functions. While governments in other countries have built real-time payment systems, the United States has relied on innovation sector to deliver real-time payment technologies. Some of those technologies are built on managed by bank consortia and some other based in independent node verification networks, such as blockchains, said OCC Brian Brooks. The President Working Group on the Financial Markets recently articulated a strong framework for using in an area of stablecoin-based financial infrastructure. Identifying important risk while allowing those risks to be managed in technology in a agnostic way. Our letter removes any legal uncertainty about the authority of bank to connect blockchains and validator nodes, and thereby transact stablecoin payments on behalf of customers who are increasingly demand the speed, efficiency, interoperability, and low cost associated with these products. So now we got two different things from the OCC in regards to custodying your cryptocurrency, your stablecoins, and if you look here during the Senate hearing, they're literally hammering Gary Glentzer around stablecoins, okay? Right here, Texas. This is, what was the date on this? June 10th, 2021. Texas state regulator greenlights banks to custody crypto. A June 10th notice from Texas Department of Banking told state and charter banks they can work with crypto companies. Okay, this is in Texas. A state charter bank in Texas have been given the green light to custody crypto assets on behalf of their customers, a state regulator announced on Thursday. The guidance is not representative of a new law, but affirmation of the state charter banks are allowed to provide crypto custody services as long as there's an adequate protocol in place and the banks are complying with existing legal frameworks, according to the June 10th notice. So worries, this is already happening. Here's the actual letter. So if you want to look, take a look at this. So this is from the operation, the OCC, July 22nd, 2020. Okay. If you go down here, where was the part I had? Sorry, I messed up. I had it all set up ready to go for you guys here. I think this is the proposed activity here. It says the bank has proposed to offer cryptocurrency custody services to its customers as part of an existing custody business. We understand that there's a growing demand for safe places such as banks to hold unique cryptographic keys associated with cryptocurrencies on behalf of customers to provide related custody services. These services are in demand for several reasons. First, because the underlying key to a unit of cryptocurrency are essentially irreplaceable if lost. Owners may lose access to their cryptocurrency as a result of misplacing their keys, resulting in significant loss of value. Second, banks may offer more secure storage services compared to existing options. Third, some investment advisors, I spelled that wrong, interesting, looks like I wrote this, may wish to manage cryptocurrencies on behalf of customers and may wish to utilize national banks. This is your operation of currency control, the head of your currency in America. This is already in place, warriors. This was in place in July. There's a thing about stable coins in January. This is already done. As they're telling you cryptocurrency is a fraud, as they're sitting there trying to fudge you out of the marketplace, the banks are already set. Bank of America has the most cryptocurrency patents. Wells Fargo's invested $5 million into a cryptocurrency company. JP Morgan has their own cryptocurrency. Bank of America is working with Ripple. Everything is set already, warriors. So the delicate tightrope that you have to walk is managing which cryptocurrencies are going to survive, because many cryptocurrencies are going to get wiped out. And what I mean by that is non-fundamental cryptocurrencies that have no real world solve. I'll give you some specific examples, okay? For example, VeChain. VeChain is a cryptocurrency that is supply chain management. It's already working with massive companies. Okay, it's going to be here. XRP is cross-border payments. We know that it's one of the biggest cases in financial history. XRP is already working in hundreds and hundreds of banks for cross-border payments. You have things like XLM. That's a sister to XRP. Jed McKillop left XRP to start XLM. It's more for consumers, right? You got things like Ethereum. Ethereum is the birth of most cryptocurrencies. You got ADA that's a little bit more efficient than Ethereum. These are protocols that are going to be here, warriors. Now, then you have things like Shiba Inu, right? You don't hear me pumping this type of stuff because it's like, it has zero utility. So do you think that's going to survive in the financial sector when regulation comes in? Absolutely not. Things like that are not going to survive, warriors, once regulation comes in. They're not going to survive. And I'm not saying Shiba Inu specifically, but that's an example of something that has zero utility. So I would highly recommend not listening to somebody sitting at the barber talking about Shiba Inu is going to make you a multimillionaire. It could, if you know the game, right? When I bought into Shiba Inu, I got into that pump and dump. I got in there. I doubled my profits and I'm sitting on a moon bag. I got my money back right away 3 days later and I'm sitting on a moon bag. So if it goes to a penny, I'm a multimillionaire. One penny. But I'm on the house money where I'm very strategic in what I do. So I always work to get my initial investment out first. Once I get my initial investment out, I work to watch the market as it goes parabolic. And I do a exit ladder strategy on the way up. So I pull profits. Guaranteed, I'll probably get more profits than about 90% of people in the market because I do not try to catch the top. I do not try to catch the bottom. I let go of my ego and my greed and I pull money and I'm working to build a diversified strategy. Precious metals to diversify against the US dollar's collapse. So that's currency stability. That creates some stability for me. Okay. Then you have the strategy of LBOs that I'm going into. Okay. So LBOs is going to be buying corporations. And then once I get educated properly, I will be buying land and I will be buying multifamily homes when I get educated properly. Right. So I'll have my real estate strategy. I'll have my wealth preservation strategy. And then I'll have my cryptocurrency, my high speculative asset strategy to gain mass amounts of profit to create that stability. So that's what we're doing. So if you want to join the Private Warrior Academy, click the link down below. You can get your guy shirts. You can get your Warriors Rise shirts. Everything's description down below. Also, my real Instagram's in the description down below. There's millions of Instagram profiles that are faking my profiles. So I do not invest people's money. I'm not on WhatsApp app. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. As we always say, Warriors, let's get your shit together. So click the description down below. Join the Private Warrior Academy today. Let's go.